So we are back once again, hoping, at this point I'm just hoping to get a nice win in Diamond with this deck. This deck treated me so well in Platinum. I would like to be treated the same way. Hey! Wins! I love it. Why? Why? Oh, okay, I guess I'll keep two. Red. I see you. You, okay, that's what I'm looking for. When it attacks, okay. What if you never attacked? I think I would like that very much. Without paying its mana cost. Okay, I know what kind of this is. Please tell me you don't have a way to destroy it. Three and oh, okay. I think I will allow that for now. That's good. Get Heliod on the board. Let's see. You know what I would really like? You're gonna kill him, aren't you? Yep. 5 damage. You did not like him. That's okay. I can bring Speaker next turn. At least have a God's Willing. Ooh. Oh, he has that. That he wants. Butts. Okay. Ooh. This is actually really convenient. Okay. One. What I could do is I could. Yeah. Don't like Steamkin. You know what, I'm gonna hold on to that. I'm very tempted though. Get rid of him first. How far away is he? There's 5 or more flame counters, okay. Discard your hand, then draw 3 cards. Good timing. Okay, I'm ready to block. Action from red. Yes, please. I will take that one. See, and actually, I could bring Heliod out next turn as well. With Abiding Grace and Serra Ascendant. You are all tapped out, my dude. Let's bring him out. He could burn a lot of stuff, so I'm not too. I don't want to lose Heliod as a creature, so I'm gonna take advantage of him at least for now. See, view battlefield. Do I have? I don't. If I had the little puppy dog. I'm actually gonna spread out my counters. I don't know what he's gonna target, but he has some hard-hitting instances that I'm not a fan of. At least with everyone as a 2-2, unless he's swinging with Den of the Bugbear. Cards, that brings Phoenix back on the board. If I gain enough life though, Serra Ascendant can get flying. Oh, we've only had a Soul Warden out because of his young Pyromancer. Oh, are you gonna burn Serra? Please don't. Pretty please. Do not. I'm. Frick. one that exiles. Ugh. No. Let's trade. Now I have a life's bounty at least. Return. Let's return speaker. So we're gonna take at least six in the air. He has a lot of cards in hand though. Well, he has three. Plus one that can escape. Let's see what he does. Here's the thing though, if I sacrifice life's bounty to protect speaker, I lose Heliod. That's the downside. But I would gain life and I can buff up. What is that? No. No, do not exile him. No, I refuse. Oh, I'm in big trouble. Wait. Wait, could I not have... I wasn't allowed to counter it? No! Wait, why couldn't I have countered it? I thought I could sacrifice. Let's see, hang on, where is that? Okay, you may cast up to one target instant card from your graveyard without paying. Exile it, copy each. But nothing says, like, it can't be countered. Color Flame deals 2 damage to any target. I think I should have. I might be wrong, but couldn't I have? I guess I couldn't have sacrificed. Ugh. That makes me so sad. Why not? Oh my goodness. Oh, I guess that's game. He has lethal in the air. I guess I did have land untapped. Let's see. So he played... This card let him cast without paying. He dealt 2 damage to any target. Can I not do this as an instant? No, I can do this as an instant. I guess the game said no. I did have untapped, but maybe I missed something. I'm still a bit confused. If y'all can see why I couldn't sacrifice Life's Bounty, please tell me in the description. Very confused, might watch that later, but yeah, oh gosh, that was not the game I was looking for, but try again tomorrow. Have a wonderful rest of your day, and I will see you next time.